Hello, hello dear Leos, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me here and sharing this beautiful space and time. Merry Christmas for those of you who celebrated Christmas this time of the year, and those of you who are going to be in the future, then Merry Christmas to you too. I'm going to walk you through the energies of planetary energies of 2024 for this rising sign of Leo. This is highly recommended because it's most accurate for you. If you are born under the rising sign of Leo, if you don't know your rising sign, please check out the link below and input your details and find your rising sign because it is the most accurate for those of you with Leo rising. However, you can watch it for your sun sign Leo and for your moon sign Leo as well. However, those are going to be talking about a different aspect of your life. Sun talks about your career aspect, and moon is more the internal feelings and your home situation. Now, if you like this video, I ask you to give me the thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the notification button as well, because these will really help the algorithm to get this video for more people, and that will inspire me to make even more videos for you. So thank you for that. Now let's jump into the planetary energies for you, dear Leo. So there's going to be a beautiful Earth Grand Trine on the 1st of January. That's why I'm in a hurry to put this video out, because that is going to be an amazing beginning of the year. We will talk about the Jupiter-Saturn cycle because they come in into two different aspects this year. We will talk about Saturn in Pisces, remains in Pisces, but Jupiter will change into exuberant Gemini. Oh yeah, Geminis. And nodes will remain in Aries, Libra, axis. Mercury will be retrograde, and every single one of them is going to be in a fire sign, according in Leo as well. And I saved the best for last, which is Pluto in Aquarius, dear Leo, which is going to completely transform your partnership, your marriage partnership. So let's begin with the Earth Grand Trine. You know how they say that the New Year resolution never lasts more than 2 weeks? Now, this one is going to be, I can guarantee you that if you have a good solid plan, what is that you set out to do? What is your intention for 2024? I highly recommend to have a little sit, have a little think about what is that you truly, truly want to manifest in the year of 2024, because you have a very good chance doing it. Now, we will have an Earth Grand Trine between Sun, Moon, and beautiful Jupiter, ever so supportive Jupiter in the sky on the 1st of January. Sun being in Capricorn, Jupiter in Taurus, and Moon in Virgo. So have a new year resolution with this grand trine in mind, in this solid sign of Capricorn, where you can achieve your goals. The sun will illuminate for you how to, what you set out to do. Once you set your mind on something, you will pursue that goal. And you know, because Capricorn is such a goal-oriented, ambitious sign, you will get support from your authorities, supported emotionally and financially. You will have a keen eye for details with Moon being in Virgo, and you'll be practical enough for the know-how. And with the Sun in Capricorn, as I said, the ambition, the perseverance will be there to reach your goals. And with Jupiter in your 10th house, it's going to be a lot of support from parents and authority figures. So this will activate your second, your sixth, and your 10th houses. So what sort of goals you should have in mind? Definitely have a financial goal, a career goal in the 10th house, and in the sixth house have maybe, I don't know, a health goal as well. These are all very much financial related and material, earthy goals as well. So, well, good luck with that. Let me know in the comment section below what is your New Year resolution. Then we have to talk about Jupiter, beautiful, supportive, ever so benevolent Jupiter. Moving, oh well, no, actually not moving, he has moved into your 10th house. However, last couple of months, Jupiter been very quiet because it has been retrograde. And within 2 days that I'm recording that, on the 30th of December, finally, Jupiter restarts moving forward again. So we will have this forward momentum in the sign of Taurus and in the house. For you, this is going to be the 10th house. So your desire for growth and expansion influences how you deal with career, with your career, with your authority figures, your ability to grow, to create wealth, wisdom, and comfort comes from the area of vocation, bosses, public achievements, social standing. The auspicious influence of Jupiter is going to affect the top of your chart, the 10th house. This is a very public position, and this can be a time when career opportunities come to you, a new career promotion, a more authoritative and visible position, which is filled with new responsibilities and prestige, can come to you now. This position will come to you and can and it is going to be like very easygoing. You know, when Jupiter gives something, there is an ease with it. There is an inspiration. So you should take it because it will give you a lot of joy and true happiness. That's what Jupiter gives, okay? So it will feel like a reward, brings abundance. That's what Jupiter brings usually, and success. Can also expand your ego. So if it's already expanded, be careful with that. Your bosses, your authority figures are very beneficial to you. You can ask them for anything. So if you want a promotion, this is the time to ask. If you want a raise in salary and therefore to take up more responsibilities, because obviously you cannot just ask for a raise, but if you offer them to take more responsibility, I think they will say yes. Now you will reach a peak and expand your public achievement, social standing, and you can stay in this one for the next 12 years to come. Jupiter in the 10th house helps you to make the right action in your career, in your vocation, in your social stand, in your public status to achieve all of this that I just mentioned. Now, Jupiter will bring the energies of the 8th and the 5th house into the 10th house. What does that mean? The 8th house is financials, the 5th house is joy, children, and creativity. So somehow these are going to affect your career. So 8th house, obviously, more responsibility can definitely affect your financial houses, but transformation, because the 8th house is also transformation, that can transform your social standing. Wow, in a good way for sure, because when Jupiter is there, it's always the good way. Fifth house then again brings lots of fun, lots of joy. Maybe you really enjoy your position, or position is connected to entertainment and children. Then Jupiter will move into your 11th house. This is also a very good position. 10th, 11th houses are very public, public houses. They're very goal-oriented. They're very achievement desire to achieve your soul's desire, your ego desire as well. So that sort of houses. So when Jupiter expands your 11th house in Gemini, you will have lots of growth and expansion, maybe, and how? By multitasking, by communicating a lot, by maybe having public speaking opportunities with larger group of people, with benefactors, with your community, with your friends, with your groups. Maybe you have public speaking having to do on the internet or in the television as well for some of you. 11th house can be television too. So your ability to grow, to create wealth is now connected to these houses, comes from these houses, and the how it's going to be the Geminian way. Okay, so be a social butterfly, communicate with everybody, put your fingers into many pies, be open, be curious, and be willing to learn, because that is really the energy of Jupiter, the energy of Gemini. Gemini also likes to write, or any type of sales communication belongs to Gemini. So if you, the know-how and the achievement has to come this way. So you will start seeing the rewards of your actions that you have done while Jupiter was in your 10th house, which they can be very financial ones, because after all, the 11th house is the gains from your career. So whatever you did in the last year, now you will see the financial rewards for that. If you're a public figure, your following can grow. And let's mention that the 11th house is also the house of titles and honors. So you will have a great opportunity to gain some of those, such as a master's degree, a PhD, of course, only if you are on that path. Now, remember, the 11th house is also connected to humanity. So just have a humanitarian goal in your mind as well. Don't be so selfish, because you will just discover extra sources of income if you don't do everything just for your sake. Okay, so have some humanitarian goals in mind as well, or something that you want to do for your community, not just purely for yourself or for your ego. Then we have to mention Jupiter being in Taurus, but conjuncting Uranus. And this is going to be the aspect of the year, you guys. It's very important. It is, all astrologers are already talking about it. It's going to happen between April the 18th and the 26th. It's a 1 week long transit, but be alert, because it's a very fast energy. It's both of the planets are connected to the future, and both of the planets are somewhat divine will and a divine awakening. So you will be awakened to maybe an opportunity. You will have a breakthrough to your career. You will have something, an innovative idea or opportunity to grow your career, because at this point, Jupiter still is going to be in your 10th house. So it is very, very difficult to predict when Uranus is around. We always say, just expect the unexpected. However, expect something positive, expect something sudden, expect something surprising, and just take the opportunity. Expect something innovative as well, out of the box. You know, think outside of the box. That's always when Uranus is around, and Jupiter will expand that. So, well, good luck with that. Please let me know if you remember. Come back to this video and let me know in the comment section down below. Then we have to talk about Saturn as well, which is a little bit more somber energy. And Saturn will go through Pisces between the 3rd and the 19th degree. Now, Saturn demolishes anything that does not have a sturdy foundation. Anything that is built in inauthenticity or in a lie, it will be now destroyed, leaving room only for things that are truly serve your purpose. Now, your houses that are covered by the mutable signs are going to be affected, are going to be challenged. So your houses, your mutable houses are going to be challenged by Saturn. First of all, Saturn is going to be in your eighth house, so it will be challenging you there. Then the opposite house, Virgo, will be challenged as well. The house of friends, groups, and communities, the 11th house, and the 5th house of children as well. So these are going to be challenged by Saturn. So if people are disappearing from these houses, like friends or a child may decide to move out, or you have some difficulty with regards to your finances, just remember that those things, incomes, and people perhaps are not serving your longer term purpose. So that's why they are disappearing. Now, you will be challenged in your eighth house, which is mostly connected to debts, insurances, inheritances. It's the house of hidden, it's the house of the occult, transformation, psychology, the house of crisis management, the house of eliminating, the cleansing, the house of power issues, deep trust, intimacy, and transformation. So you will be called upon to make a little bit more efforts into this area. So how this can manifest? Maybe you have a partner whose income and the cash flow will be somewhat limited, maybe due to an illness, maybe they lose their jobs, I don't know. But somehow that income, which is the support from another person, will be limited. Now, if you don't have one of these, maybe a tax, an alimony, a child support, maybe an insurance now will be blocked, will be limited. The cash flow will also be limited because obviously the eighth house is affecting the second house too, which is your income, your resources, your assets. So, one affects the other one as well. So maybe someone's death is going to impact you somehow, or maybe you are going to be acquiring actually an inheritance. Without a doubt, you will have to be forced, you will be forced to restructure, to reorganize some of your mutual resources that maybe you have been saving up for something long term. Hence, you need to manage your assets with more responsibility, with more maturity. The eighth house is a very transformational house where some shocking and sudden events may happen, and so transformation can take place. These sudden things sometimes happen due to a crisis situation, and you are needing to manage that for the next 1.5 years to come, because this is how long Saturn will still stay there. Look at the degrees between the 3 and the 19th degree of those mutual houses I mentioned below, because those are going to be affected, and if there are planets, the houses that are ruled by those planets are also going to be affected. The ultimate goal of the eighth house is to give you emotional strength. So we don't like the saying, but I have to say, what doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. A sense situation will occur where you need to be where you need to learn how to stay strong, emotionally stable, even in roller coaster situations. So let's see, just to wrap up, what sort of things may happen to you. You have to reorganize, restructure your shared finances. You have to draw up, you might end up drawing up a will or taking out a life insurance. You will be exploring the mysteries of life. You will be have to confront your past and maybe heal some aspects of it. And you will achieve some self-mastery. Now, on the negative side, there could be some loss of essential resources and money and income. You might be trapped in a bad financial deal. It can come out as an emotional purgatory, and you might end up having to face some mortality, and that's why you're taking out a deal. A will and or a life insurance. Okay, now let's talk about the Jupiter-Saturn cycle that began on the 20th of December 2020. This happened on the 0 degree of Aquarius, and it is affected your seventh house of relationship. So something probably you began around that time. This was the time when COVID began, and I know it was life-altering for many, many people. And so I don't know what is the project that you began. I will walk you through the possible ideas in a minute. But now the project will come into the first initial sprouts, a little growth might show up, and a little opportunity that is coming from, again, from the public or your authority figures as well, because Jupiter benevolently influences from there. So this is going to happen at the beginning of the year, all the way till the 4th of March. But then towards the end of the year, so just be happy with that, cherish that, because towards the end of the year you will have some challenges towards those plans. Jupiter and Saturn will come to a square aspect now, and this will take place between the 21st of August and the 25th of December. They will have three hits, and out of the three hits, how the first one will bring up the subject, the second one will be a really hard hit where you really have to take some very serious actions and adjustment, and the third one will resolve it for better or for worse. So things going to be a little bit uncomfortable. It will be some reality checks, some cleaning up to do, some adjustment to do. Challenge will be coming, maybe some financial challenge, maybe something from your groups and communities, because this time around now Jupiter is has will have moved into Gemini, to your 11th house. So this is a cosmic conflict between expansion. Jupiter wants to expand and Saturn wants to contract, and they don't have an understanding. So that's some frustration going on there that will put you into action. So just take everything slow. It is a reality check. Just lay down one brick at a time. Just remember, you don't have to build a road at once. Rome was not built in a day, and you don't have to do it either. This is a long-term plan. The Jupiter Saturn cycle, they take 20 years to come into a full circle. Okay, so you will have plenty of time. Don't rush. Take everything very cautiously, plan everything out, and think about what is the next move that will take this business, this project, a little bit more forward. Now, Pluto will be there on the 0 degrees of Aquarius, further activating, intensifying the degree. So some intensity, some unearthing of some hidden issues may come, and that also may cause some challenge. So what could that be? What could that be? What could that be, that plan that you began in 2020 December? Maybe a plan connected to partnerships, business partnerships, clientele, a new contract, a new agreement, something to do with your audience if you have one, or something to do with any collaborative project, a marriage plan, a business project. So any one of these, but Jupiter and Saturn most likely, they do bring something more business related than love related. Okay, now let's talk about the nodes of the moon. The nodes of the moon are the points of karma. North node is our future karma. That's where we are heading. And the south node is the past karma that we are releasing. And so these are very important because these are activating the eclipses. And so some major endings and some great new beginnings are going to happen in your axis of travel and education, on your third and ninth house axis. These are more likely to feel fated, destined, as though you don't have much control over them, those situations. But just remember, the universe is only putting you on a path that you are already chosen and agreed upon just before you arrive to this physical reality. Ninth house represents international travels, beliefs, higher studies. Above average opportunities might come to you now, maybe from a teacher, maybe from a mentor, a guardian, some sort of guardian, maybe a foreigner, a charismatic person, maybe on a trip abroad, or whilst you're studying in a university, or any sort of higher developmental course or self-development. You will become very active in your studies. You want to expand your horizon, which will develop you spiritually, morally. Rahu makes you very ambitious. So it is a very, very good time to study now something, because you're going to be so hungry for knowledge that you will just devour everything. All the books and all the knowledge existing is going to be there for you to intake. There will be opportunities to study abroad, and you will discover spiritual and higher knowledge that will make you understand your purpose, your goal, the meaning of life a little bit more. The third house is your local environment, in the other hand, your communication, the people you meet on an everyday basis, and some that you will want to detach from them. You want to release them. You could disconnect a little bit from people in your local environment, such as neighbors. Of course, if you will be traveling, this is only natural, right? Such as your neighbors, maybe your siblings, your teammates. You're not much of a team player nowadays because you want to follow your own truth. You may disconnect from social media too. You say, do you know what? My head is with my more lofty idea than just be on and, you know, scroll on Facebook, which is nothing bad about that. All right, let's talk about Mercury retrograde in the fire signs, which will occupy your first house in Leo, fifth and ninth house. The first one is going to be in April, between 1st and 25th of April in Aries. Oh, it was going to be in your ninth house, so expect some fiery miscommunications there, or some delays and some troubles with regards to your, or misunderstandings with regards to learning and traveling. The second one will happen in the second house of Virgo, but it backtracks to your sign between the 5th and 28th of April, and the third one is going to happen between November 26th and December 15th, that is going to be in your fifth house in Sagittarius, connected to your children and creativity. So when Mercury retrogrades in the fire signs, you have to embrace and awaken your competitive spirit. You want to take risks in life and be excited about your future. You want to think about your glory, your greatness, your level of enthusiasm. You have to look at what is that you are believe, what do you believe is going to bring positivity for your life. Okay, to be active, to get noticed for something. What motivates you? What gives you this inner fuel to go on, to be passionate? Now, remember that fire can consume you, so just be a little bit more contained with that. Okay, don't go full speed. Right, so I left the best for last, which is Pluto in Aquarius. This Pluto will have a profound effect on humanity as a whole, in a collective, and on us as individuals as well. It's going to stay there till 2044. It already gave us a sneak peek. That's when AI came into our consciousness. I don't know if you remember, this was Pluto went into Aquarius this year between March and June, and AI all of a sudden was all around the news, and suddenly everybody started using. Now, these are only the initial impulses. You just watch what is going to unfold in the next 20 years. Oh my goodness. Yeah, there's going to be some technological developments, all right? This AI is nothing in comparison. But on your individual level, Pluto is going to be in your seventh house. Now, please do understand there will be some positive and some negative manifestations of that as well. Positively, your marriage will definitely take into an unprecedented deep level. You have to examine your real truths behind your core close personal relationships. Your relationship, your partnerships will be transforming, going very deep, very intense, with penetrating people. There will be some obsession, there will be some control issues, some manipulation, some deep hidden secrets coming into light, some sexuality, the dark side, or it all depends what Pluto touches in your horoscope. If it touches Mars and Venus, then definitely going to be some, you know, some deep tantric sexual experiences for sure. But you can find your soulmate now, and your marriage will be totally, totally transformed. It has to be, otherwise it's going to end up in a divorce. So oftentimes, if marriage is under a shaky ground already, they will end, marriage falls apart, resulting in a divorce. That's exactly what happened when Pluto touched my descendant, which is, you know, the sensitive point exactly opposite my ascendant. It was dead. It was not, we were, but we were We were already on the shaky ground. So I'm not saying this had to happen to everybody, but you will definitely have to transform it. Okay, some manipulation, abuse, or power struggles can come out as well on the negative side. Try to engage with the positive side of Pluto, because if you use manipulation, control, and power issues with your partner, the energy can go either way. Either you use it or they use it against you. Then Pluto can really drag you down to the underworld. So there could be some trauma that will be discovered in personal relationships, which can lead to breakdown. Can be some obsession with regards to partners. So the seventh house Pluto can really lead to turning your marriage 100% around, to transform it, to take it to another level of intimacy and intense blending with your partner as well. But more commonly, sometimes divorce and separation can result as well from old modes of behavior that cannot be longer tolerated. So what was suppressed, it will definitely come out. What was secret was definitely come out. What was swept under the carpet now will definitely come out. So you will have to deal with all of that. Good luck. I mean, this can be beautiful as well. So don't just take the negative, but just be very cautious with the energy of Pluto. It can be a little bit, obsessive. Well, that's all I had for you, dear Leo. I thank you very, very much for joining me here and honoring me with your time. I wish you a beautiful 2024, a beautiful renewed marriage, and the manifestation of all your New Year resolution. Thank you so much. And please like and subscribe. Thank you. Bye bye.